So today we are making ragi protein crepes. Crepes which are basically pancakes which you can make at home, which you can make for a party, you can make for breakfast. What we've done is we've fortified this particular crepe by adding two various flours in that. The two flours that I'm using today, one is barley flour and one is ragi flour. I'm also using a little bit of protein powder which is already mixed inside this. Now the reason we wanted to make it a little different is because, you know, a lot of people were complaining that, you know, maida is becoming a problem for them. So this is a recipe that you can easily make without maida. Also, one of the things which you can look at is you can make this recipe without eggs as well. You can make this recipe completely vegan by removing the eggs and replacing it with flaxseed paste. You can replace the milk which is in this by using almond milk or coconut milk. And the flours remain. We're still looking at a keto version of this. So let's look. Let's see. Let's hope that in the future we have to crack this. The recipe is already on our page, which is Foodie Breaks India. You can like our page so that you can keep getting updates about what we do here. Let's just check out the ingredients first. Then I'll just start doing that. So we've got salt. We've got barley flour. Looks a lot like maida, but this is barley flour. Add in the salt. And we've got a little bit of the ragi flour and the protein powder mixed up together. Everything's gone in. The reason I'm taking out two is because sometimes one is too less. So two is better. Makes a good quantity of batter. Usually one good size crepes. So what I've done is I've just basically mixed this up using a whisk so that all the ingredients are well mixed. One of the key things is to sift these ingredients. So please pass them through a sieve so that these ingredients get cleaned of any kind of debris, or if there's any kind of foreign particle inside the flour, it gets removed away. What you can also do is you can also sift this and keep it in places. If you're living in a place which is less humidity, unlike Goa, you can also sift this and keep it for a period of up to sift before use. That's the safest way to use it. The next thing that we're doing is basically once we've got this, we're going to line up the milk in this. Now I'm using milk. If you are vegan, you can just replace this with almond milk or coconut milk. It works equally well. It might feel a little lumpy to you, but don't worry about it. Now here you notice I don't have any sugar. So the reason I've not added any sugar is because we have honey. So honey makes a very good sweetener for this particular combination. So I'm adding the honey in as well. Replace honey, for example, if you're completely vegan, you can replace it with I'm going to give this a nice mix. So this kind of smells like malt right now. It smells like Complan to a certain extent. So you get that kind of smell, it's pretty much okay. The next thing is going in is basically some eggs. So we'll crack an egg. There's a lot of mystery that surrounds using the egg yolks in a particular recipe, but research keeps changing every now and then. So currently people say that it's healthier to use whole eggs, so we're using whole eggs. We're adding the oil. can add a little bit of vanilla essence if you want. A little bit of vanilla essence, if in case you just want to mask the flavor of the, just half a cap. We don't need it to have vanilla flavor per se, but a little bit of vanilla flavor never harmed anybody. This is done. And as usual, we put it into a nice little jug. Pour it slowly. Just take a spatula and just take everything off so you don't have any wastage. So these crepes are going to be a little thicker than the normal average French crepe. It's going to be a little bit more denser than them. But that's pretty much okay. Cool. So we'll get started on the baking of this right away. So what we're going to do now is we're going to first make all the crepes on this induction. Now the issue with the induction is that it only has surface heating in this area. That's only this area. So it's always better to keep the pancake centered right in the middle here. So let's get a little bit of heat. With a little bit of the residual oil that is there, you only need to do this for the first pancake. The first pancake, this is necessary. After that, you don't need to do any of that. Always tidy up your area. What is happening? So this can be served traditionally with chocolate sauce, can serve it with butterscotch sauce, can serve it with absolutely any kind of sauce you want. But since it's ragi, I'm going to serve it with a little bit of homemade mango sauce, mango sesame. Now this is getting hot. I'm going to pour the just let it. This is an open flame, it will be easier to cook this much, much faster. The moment you start seeing bubbles appear here, that means this is cooked, so you need to flip it. Flip it like that. Then bring this in the center. Just cook it ever so gently. You don't have to be very rough with it. It's very delicate. Just cook it ever so gently. This is a batter, so it'll cook really fast. Plus, eggs also cook very fast. So it's not going to take too much time to on the heat, you know. Some chefs would argue that this oil is not necessary. I also agree that it's not necessary. But sometimes we are better off having a little bit of oil there. Go to the next one. And keep repeating this. And even make it thinner. Once you get the hang of it, make it thinner and thinner and thinner. here once you can, once you've got this, you just fold it like that. For the moment we'll just keep it like that, so it just cools down a little bit when this one cools. So if you're using the induction for the first time, I've kept it on an automatic induction mode, which is usually curry or boil, and I've taken the heat down to 600. I'm using a Morphy Richards induction. Whichever one you use, make sure the heat is not very intense. So don't put it on the full heat. Try to take it down to at least 600 or 800 reading on the induction. Again, you can see a little bit bubbles coming on top. Once you see the bubbles coming, that means it's starting to cook. So you can start prepping to flip it over. Again, ever so gently. If you manage to stick it like that, you can just use your hands to flip it. Be careful, it's a little hot. So this is, can you imagine now, this is completely without any flour here. There's no flour involved in this. It's only barley. There's only barley and ragi flour. There's no wheat flour in this. So those of you that have gluten allergy can probably opt for this product. Gently just roll it around. That's the last one that we'll be getting. We still have half the batter left. We'll use half the batter later. You can still conserve this batter in the fridge for about 2 hours more. The batter will not get spoiled in the fridge, but in 2 hours try to use it up. Because there's egg in there, you don't want to take a risk with that. Ensure that the crepes don't get too much color. If it colors a lot, then it's also problematic for this product. Flip it. Only a couple of minutes, this is also done. In the meantime, what you're going to do is you're just going to roll these guys up. So if you find any place which you want to cover up, you can. it's going to absorb all that heat away from the pan. Next, what you're going to do is you're going to make the sauce right in the same pan. So it's going to be easier for you to understand how to use that as well. The same pan, what you're going to do is you're going to take some sesame seeds. And we're just going to roast them. But this will start to pop very soon. The moment they start to pop like that, you know that they are roasted. You'll see the color change almost immediately. While that's happening, I'm going to add some mango juice. A spoonful of butter. This is mango because it's mango season now, so you want to use mango, and mango for me personally goes very well with sesame, so you can try to deglaze this like this. You can also use orange if you want to use orange or any kind of citric fruit. Little bit of honey. I mean, let this come to a boil. When this comes to a boil, this is done. So we are absorbing all the flavor from that particular, from the previous product. We are absorbing it into this particular sauce. You can check the consistency of this product. It's nice and soft. So it's not, you don't really require any flour, kind of any refined flour either to make this product. It comes out very well without doing it either. Increase the heat so you can just deglaze this. Let it come to a boil. And you can draw a line in the sauce so that the sauce goes to the back of the spoon. When it goes to the back of the spoon like this, that means the sauce is done. Nice sesame smell coupled with the mango and a little bit of butter and honey. You can make it like a nice honey butter sauce. And that you can spoon over. Serve it with it or serve it separately. That is done. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know how that, do try this out. Let me know how it tastes. I hope you guys have a fun Sunday. Keep baking. If you need any kind of updates from us regarding our upcoming courses, like us on Facebook. That's facebook.com/foodiebreaksindia. Follow us on Instagram. This will be posted on Instagram as well. That's instagram.com/foodiebreaks. FWODYBREAKS. I'm Kunal, signing off. Thanks so much for joining us. Keep joining us every Saturday. We do some crazy things like this. Hopefully we'll come up with some better things as we progress through these days. And one thing I want to just point out is next Saturday we'll be in Bombay doing a very simple demo. Again, we hope to have a keto demo next Saturday. evening. So that will be done in Bombay. Do catch us for that. Even that video will be posted live on the page. Thanks so much for joining us. Cheers. Bye-bye.